Okay, I figured I'd do a little video on this Husqvarna 22 that I got. It's one that I bought, it came from Tradex years ago, but it was like a parts gun when I bought it, and it was like taped together. It didn't have any screws holding the action onto the stock and stuff, but and it had some other problems too, so I got it. It's pretty much fully repaired. I just got to get like a front sight and stuff on it. But I dug it out the other day. I was like, I should finish that because it's nice little gun overall. Like it appears to be like it was a model 55. It's got the automatic safety on it. But it was rebarreled at one time. Like it's got a round barrel on it, which is not correct for the model, but if you look at the stock, which appears to be original, you can see where there's flats in here where it did have an octagon barrel at one time. And I think by the serial number, it's like a fairly early one. So it probably just, you know, the barrel got corroded or, you know, because there was still corrosive primers, possible black powder 22 ammo. Because I've got another one that's, I don't know if it's the same age or not, but it's quite old as well, and it's actually got a, like the bore is still sort of okay-ish, but it's, you know, it's dark and it's got a little bit of pitting and stuff. It's the one that's in my, remade those black powder 22 cases that I made up. I was shooting them in that gun. But it was, like when I got it, I think the hole was here, I think. There was a hole drilled down. I can't remember if it was tapped or not, but it was, went right down through the receiver ring right into the barrel. And the barrel on this is basically brand new. Like it's, you can see it's still got good bluing and everything. You can see the, compared to the receiver, compared to the blue on this. And this back sight looks like it was probably off the old barrel. It's like that fixed, I don't know if those are 50 meter or what, but because there's no other markings. This is Husqvarna Vapen Fabriques and then AB caliber 22. And anyway, so it was rebarreled, then somebody drilled a hole in it and screwed it up. So it was sold as a parts gun. Like it, you can see where the hole for the forearm was here. So anyway, basically got like 2.5 inches of the barrel cut off to get rid of the bad spot and then put it back in, and then got it reamed out and cut the new little groove for the extractor and stuff to go, and there's the new hole for the screw in the forearm goes. You can see where the swivel used to be. It doesn't, I don't know if I can make up something for that or not, but these holes are like really tiny little screws. And then that's for the front sight, but I dug around through my stuff. I didn't find something that really fits, but I suppose I can make something, but because they had a fairly, like this sight here is fairly low, so the front sight's be a fairly low kind of like inverted V. Should be fine. And it's, since it's cut a little bit, it's got like a, basically from the breech face to the end, it's like a 22 inch barrel, which is a good length for a 22. It's a nice handy. It doesn't really have a bolt that's for it. There's, I can't remember if the bolt with this one was missing parts. I think it was missing like the cocking piece, but one of them I took the bolt and I took like the extractor off one to fix one of my other ones. And so there's like one bolt that goes with basically three of them. It works in all of them, so it's just whatever. It doesn't matter. I just can, whatever one I feel like using at the time, I can just get the bolt and put it in that one. So you can see it had a, there's a pin that holds the barrel on. But, so anyway, so it's a good little, get a front sight on it, and But yeah, overall, it's a good little late weight, sort of short, handy rabbit gun, and it's just fixed sights. I don't have to look at the other ones I got, because I think one of the other ones has a sight about that height. I could just make something and then cut it down to get it so it shoots sort of on around, I don't know, 25 yards or whatever. I think some of them had like a fixed 50 meter sight on them, but so. But look at little guns. And the stock is a nice slim little stock. I think it's been pine tarred. It looks like it's, where was it? Kind of see here, it's kind of like the when you put the tar on it and then you heat it, it kind of bubbles out and it leaves these little those little dried little pebbles of like tar, and it looks quite dark, like in here and stuff like that. It was one time, so it probably was done. I just need a swivel for there, but you can see it was a parts gun. Like everything that was sort of, they could take off the thing and use somewhere else. Sort of, I guess they took it because somebody boogered up the drilling hole in the barrel. So I don't know what they were trying to do. They were trying to put a scope base on it or whatever. I'm pretty sure it was right here, right down into the. They always do it with like perfect barrels. They always, they don't mess up the bad guns, but I guess people don't want to convert the bad guns. So. Anyway, thanks for watching, and talk to you later.